Hello students, now we'll be solving memory based question of GATE 2019. For more video solution on GATE 19, subscribe to our channel and don't forget to click bell icon for instant notifications.
Hello students, I am Ayush Rathore. In this video, we are going to solve a question from the manufacturing from chapter welding. Let us discuss the problem. Which one of the following welding method provides the highest heat flux? Listen to the question very carefully. Which one of the following welding method provides the highest heat flux? The unit is given watt per mm square. Options are given. A is equals to oxyacetylene. B is given TIG. C option is given LBM, laser beam welding, plasma arc welding. These are the options given. And the question is like, which one of the following welding method provides the highest heat flux? And the unit is given watt per mm square. How to tackle this kind of problems? Let us discuss it. We know that in TIG, oxyacetylene and POM, Heat affected zone is very large. So heat affected zone is very large. So here heat affected zone is very large in three of this. What is the heat flux will be? Heat flux decreases. But in LBM, because heat is concentrated at a particular narrow slot only, heat affected zone is very less. So therefore, heat flux is maximum in LBW, that is laser beam welding. So from heat affected zone concept, we can calculate the we can get the answer of heat flux. So in oxyacetylene, TIG and plasma arc welding, in these three, heat affected zone is high. So it is higher, therefore heat flux is lesser. In LBW, laser beam welding, heat affected zone is minimum, therefore heat flux is maximum. So hope you like this video. Please don't forget to like and share this video with your friends, and thank you.